school teacher. I teach English composition. This little town called Adley, Pennsylvania. In the last 11 years, I've been at Thomas Alva Edison High School. I was a coach of the baseball team in springtime. Back home, and I tell people what I do for a living, they think, well, not that big. But over here, it's a big mystery. So I guess I've changed some. Sometimes I wonder if I've changed so much, my wife is even gonna recognize me whenever it is I get back to her.
So with that scene right there, just kind of goes in bringing back the reality of the situation and why they're actually there and how it is being they portray him as such a hierarchy of a person that they can't even getting on a real level with him, that he's still just a human being himself, and that the fact he just wants to finish his mission and go home just like everybody else. So going to the second speech and kind of talking about logos and pretty much the logical side of things. So the Army's faced with a decision that depends on logic. To persuade, so the idea that is when they're trying to save Ryan, obviously, what's the point of saving one guy compared to when they can go save everybody else? But the idea is to save that family gene line. And General, is General MacArthur in this movie? No, General Marshall, excuse me. He's the one that puts in the logical side of things and tries to imply that this is something very important that needs to happen. And this is another video I'll show you quick on Abraham Lincoln's speech.
I have a letter here. Written a long time ago to a Mrs. Bixby in Boston. Bear with me. Dear Madam, I have been shown in the files of the War Department a statement of the Adjutant General of Massachusetts that you are the mother of five sons who have died gloriously on the field of battle. I feel how weak and fruitless must be any words of mine that would attempt to beguile you from the grief of a loss so overwhelming. But I cannot refrain from tendering to you the consolation that may be found in the thanks of the Republic they died to save. I pray that our Heavenly Father may assuage the anguish of your bereavement. Leave you only the cherished memory of the loved and lost. The solemn pride that must be yours to have laid so costly a sacrifice upon the altar of freedom. Yours very sincerely and respectfully, Abraham Lincoln.
And what seeing that, then, that was kind of the, I guess, the playing of why they decided to go on the mission. Finishing up, we're not there. Should get like a minute to duck out of this. Okay, so in conclusion, kind of going over the ethos and kind of the ethical side of things. Obviously, the mission to save one guy instead of saving everybody else and trying to imply the whole logical reasoning of doing this mission, it just kind of goes to show that it's a different experience when you actually kind of get out on the, I guess, the war side of scenes and trying to relate from being just a standard citizen to actually being a military person. And just kind of leaving note, this is actually James Ryan at the end of the movie. He's kind of paying his last final respects to Captain Miller, who's the one that actually reached out and sacrificed himself to end up saving him so he can grow up and have his own family someday, and kind of express that gratitude. And that's it.